Map views use the display data location and build surface maps. Open the map view via the control panel, View, Map View. I can locate this project geographically by viewing it alongside a georeferenced culture file. Culture files are turned on or off via the Culture tab. To see the whole region, right-click and select Zoom to Fit. Our map view displays a culture of Northwest Australia, with our project located in the Carnarvon Basin. The Display tab has general controls on background color, label size, and line label display. I can use polygons and other objects to constrain the view extents to a smaller area of interest. Right-click and drag to zoom closer to the 3D survey. We can use the Draw tab to annotate Barrow Island using a text box. Right-click again and drag to zoom to the 3D survey. Use mouse button 1 to pan the display into position. Scroll the mouse wheel for small zoom adjustments. The navigation bar runs along the top of the view. Display a time slice by selecting the full stack volume in the Volume tab. Then toggle the amber traffic light next to the two-way time label to green to display the slice value defined in the slice box. Scroll through the time volume by the displayed increment by using the up-down arrows, middle mouse scroller, or up-down hotkeys. Change the increment to a higher number to scroll with bigger steps. Notice that the slice intersections with the deviated wells are marked with a small cross. The domain selector can be switched to depth or the flattened domain for a more stratigraphic view, as I have done here. Just look at those fantastic channels. Turn off the time slice and display a picked horizon. Using the Display tab, horizons can be displayed with custom contours or with fault intersections. Interpreted polygons can be added to the display for a more structural map. I can display various horizon properties depending on the data available. For example, quickly displaying a depth map or RMS amplitude extraction. Notice that I can keep two-way time contours whilst changing attributes. Click the spanner to quickly edit the horizon settings. That's better. Horizon settings is also available via the right-click menu, and if you need to keep a permanent copy of the attribute, you can save it as a custom property here. Move the cursor over the horizon prospect in Map View, and watch as the information bar along the bottom updates. Operations tab contains various useful horizon operations, such as regrid, interpolate extrapolate, and horizon maths. It's worth exploring these in more detail. The online manual is a useful first step. For example, our horizons may be too jagged, so create a new smoothed horizon using the smooth operation and recalculate the contours. By saving as a new horizon, the original horizon is still there if you need the extra detail. Want to quickly calculate the area of a potential prospect? Use the Geometry tab. Select or draw a temporary polygon to define the region. Tick Area. Volume can be calculated by entering top and base horizon or constant. Our separate volumetrics tool can be used for more in-depth analysis. Don't forget to keep track of domain when using volumetrics. Only depth domain will give a correct estimate of volume. In the Annotation tab, we can display lat longs in decimal degrees, the north arrow, scale bar, and horizon color bar. We can also add a title. The camera icon in the top left-hand side takes a screenshot which can be scaled and saved to PNG. If you have questions or would like to discover more, then visit our website at www.dug.com. And remember, have fun with Insight!